Everybody loves a Mars rover, whether it's Spirit and Opportunity and their incredible adventures across the Martian landscape, or Curiosity and the mysteries it has uncovered regarding an ancient lake bed on Mars. These rovers excite our inner passion for space exploration and allow us to envision a future where one day humans are on Mars. The next rover to go is Perseverance, which is already making its way towards Mars as of right now. NASA's Perseverance rover, or Percy for short, is aiming to uncover the mysteries of ancient life on Mars. And in order to do so, it will be pushing the boundaries in both science and engineering to try and answer four major goals. In this video, we will be discussing those major mission goals and understanding some of the details as to why those goals are important. So let's talk about that. The first goal of the Perseverance rover is to have an understanding of the geological composition of the landing site. Percy is currently traveling at roughly 60,000 miles per hour, or 100,000 kilometers per hour, towards a location on Mars called Jezero Crater. Now, Jezero Crater, by looking at a map of Mars, is located at 18 degrees north and 77 degrees east. Here, we can see a closer image of the crater, or an elevation image, where the circle shows where exactly Percy is planning to land. Now, this region is going to pose quite a challenge for NASA engineers, because it's going to be one of the trickiest landing sites that NASA has ever done on Mars. The reason is because of the high cliff sides, the boulder fields, and the sand dunes all throughout this region. So you might be wondering, why would NASA choose such a tricky place to land? And if we take a look at Jezero Crater, or at least the landing site once again, we can start to understand why it's so important. Not only do scientists believe that Jezero Crater was once an ancient lake on Mars, but also the specific location that Percy is aiming for is what could have been an ancient river delta. Now here on Earth, there are plenty of river deltas, and essentially these are most commonly found where rivers meet a larger body of water. Essentially, these regions have high buildup of various types of sediments, most specifically clay. Now, this is important because here on Earth, clay has been found to preserve ancient microbes, or microbes that are billions of years old. Therefore, if we're trying to find evidence of life or ancient life on Mars, one of the best locations will be where there's a lot of clay deposits. So, if this really was an ancient river delta, and there is clay in these deposits on Mars, this could be a perfect location for Percy to look for ancient life. Speaking of preserving microbes in clay, this leads us to the second mission goal, being the search for evidence of ancient life. The big question when talking about life off of Earth is, are we alone? But the Perseverance rover isn't looking for some abandoned space station or even womp rats, but rather it's trying to find life at the smallest form and whether or not it could have once existed on Mars. Now, this is a very challenging problem to answer, and that's why they've broken it up into smaller questions. The first question being, was Mars once habitable, or could Mars have ever supported life at all? And if so, then they can ask the question, did Mars ever support life? The first step to addressing these questions is the evidence of liquid water. Now, the reason why this is important is because here on Earth, nearly anywhere where we find liquid water, we find life. No matter the temperature regions or even the acidity of the water, typically we can find some form of life form that has existed in that region. Therefore, if Mars has the evidence of vast amounts of liquid water on its surface, then that's one of the key indicators that life could have potentially formed there. And the scientific community over the last few decades has vastly improved upon their understanding of an ancient Mars, and the fact that maybe billions of years ago, it could have been much like that of Earth. Which is why NASA is starting to ask whether or not life could have once existed on Mars. Now, Percy will search for organic matter in the various composition of the sediments and rock samples that it selects from Jezero Crater, essentially collecting evidence or clues towards whether or not an ancient Mars, well, held life. And fitting enough, two of the experiments that are on board Percy right now are called SHERLOC and Watson to try and uncover the mysteries of an ancient Mars. This leads us to the third mission goal, to prepare for future missions. As the Perseverance rover explores across Jezero Crater, it will collect various soil samples, rock samples, much like other rovers have done in the past. However, it will also be setting aside some of these samples in their own canisters, sealed, and then leave them on the surface. Now, the reason for this is because NASA in the future might be sending up another lander mission. But instead of just landing on the surface and exploring, similar to the Phoenix and InSight landers, it's going to have a small fetch rover, which will go and collect some of these samples that Percy leaves behind, and then it will launch those samples back to Earth. This will be an incredibly ambitious mission, as nothing has ever launched from Mars before, nor have we ever sent something back from the Red Planet. So this will be an incredibly hard technological feat. However, Percy is acting as the first step by collecting some of these rock samples. The reason why NASA would want to bring Mars samples back to Earth is because Percy is limited by the amount of experiments it can run. Now, don't get me wrong, the Perseverance rover is incredibly advanced. It's state-of-the-art in its engineering design and scientific instruments. However, it's still limited because these instruments can only be so big. You can't send an entire laboratory to Mars, therefore everything has to be condensed down to save in weight and size in order to actually get to the Red Planet. Therefore, if we're able to bring samples back to Earth, then we can use our laboratories on the ground that have a lot higher resolution and are able to test a lot of different components of the samples themselves. Therefore, a Mars sample return mission could give us a lot more information about these samples that exist on Mars. However, again, that's something that still needs to be planned for the future. Percy is just acting as the first step, which is collecting these samples and caching them for eventually a future mission. Percy also has a partner on board, being Ingenuity. Ingenuity is an incredibly small helicopter, weighing in at about 4 pounds or having a mass of 1.8 kilograms. Now, this helicopter is essentially being a technology demonstrator for what could eventually be future flying missions, whether it be on Venus, Mars, or even one of Saturn's moons. Essentially, Ingenuity is going to try and help NASA understand the difficulties associated with flying something on another planet. And as someone that has flown some remote controlled planes before, I know that can be incredibly difficult. However, most of this is going to be completely autonomous, just doing a short test flights to see whether or not it can get off the ground, safely land, and then do some side maneuvers. But eventually, if Ingenuity and all the tests it runs go well, then what will end up happening is they can use it for navigation. Ingenuity will be able to fly over cliff sides or local hills to help Perseverance navigate throughout Jezero Crater. If everything goes according to plan, then it'll be exciting to see the aerial images that we get back from Ingenuity and how we can use those images to traverse across Mars. The fourth and final goal is to test technology for human exploration. As of right now, NASA's directive is to go sustainably back to the moon and then onto Mars. However, there is still a lot we need to learn about the Red Planet before we can send people there safely. And one part of Percy is having the MOXIE instrument. MOXIE essentially is going to take carbon dioxide out of the Martian atmosphere and convert it into oxygen gas. Now, this is important, obviously, for human exploration because humans need oxygen to breathe. But also, oxygen is usually used in various types of rocket fuel. Therefore, if the MOXIE experiment is successful, this can help in the design of future instruments that could be sent to Mars and can collect oxygen from the atmosphere rather than having to send it all at once. Additionally, Percy will be testing spacesuits, but it won't be wearing one. Instead, there are just small samples attached to the rover. So as it goes throughout its mission, it will be able to assess how much those samples have degraded and what design might be best for when humans actually go to the Red Planet. Like every Mars mission, NASA is asking some really big questions. And for every single one of the questions and goals that I addressed in this video, there are a million tiny little details. Which is why this is going to be the first video of many on the Perseverance rover. Much like my videos on the InSight lander, I'm going to go into depth on the various instruments on board Percy, as well as some of the systems or subsystems for the engineering design, as well as the scientific outcomes of the mission. So if you have any questions about the Perseverance rover, let me know in the comments below. If there's any videos that you'd want to see specifically done about this rover again, let me know below. If you're interested in following along on Perseverance's journey, please consider subscribing and following this channel to see what comes out in the future. But thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.